So today we are going to talk about Deathstroke. Yes, he is the deadliest assassin for DC. And this is by Tunius Daniel, Sanda Flora and Tommy Murray. It's volume 1, Gods of War. Deathstroke, in my mind at least, he is like an equivalent of Wolverine in X-Men. Or like brutality, death, action, that's how I will put him across. But if you are purchasing this book, which is Volume 1, Gods of War, I think it's from New 52. The one part that will clearly come through is it's full of action, right? And you could clearly see a lot of artwork from Tonius Daniel coming across here, like you could see in these panels. And that for me is kind of like the highlight of this collection. More than the story is passable, but nothing extraordinary. If you are a fan of Wolverine and you would want to see a similar kind in DC with DC set of characters, heroes and villains featuring, then this is one book you can go for. That's how I'll put it. Just taking you through some of the panels in it so that you could see the artwork coming through. And yeah, there are a lot of double page splash panels which shows the kind of action that you would want to see in this kind of books. So this is essentially a book where Deathstroke has to go and fight for his family, and interestingly even the main villain is also part of his family, and he undergoes some set of transformations. And yeah, that's one transformation of him. It's like a reincarnation. But yeah, art again by Tonius Daniel, and that's something of the highlight of this book. Yeah, again the two page splash pages, and then again completely jumping into action. I think Deathstroke also reminds me a lot of Deadpool. I don't know if who came first, Deadpool or Deathstroke. The name sign kind of like sounds very similar, but except that there's no comedy around Deathstroke, right? It's all serious stuff and serious action. So that's where I put him in the pool of Wolverine rather than in Deadpool, right? But you kind of like get it, right? Both, all these three characters, it's more like a fun action packed read. And if you are a fan who enjoys a lot of artwork around those action, then this is one book you should definitely plan to get. And I think some of the highlights in this book again is the characters who appear. One is obviously Harley Quinn, and you could see her coming here. And then there is a big appearance that is what I'm going to take you to quickly, because I don't want to spend too much time on like showing you the entire book. But and that page is this, right, where he comes face to face with Batman, obviously all thanks to Harley. And then the action that follows, I think, is one of the most coolest action fights between both of these guys. So just for that, I felt this book is really good to see a brilliant fight between Batman and Deathstroke. So I would say in terms of artwork, this book should get around 4, 4.5-ish. And for the story, I think it will be around a 2.5. Not a great fan of how the story is, right? But as you guys could see clearly in these panels, the kind of artwork and the fights that happened is something which, if you get it for a good price, right? Like 1/3 of the actual price. The actual price is around $1,000 in India. So then I think I would recommend you to go and get it. But don't get it for full price. It's not worth it, for sure. And it goes on and on. And I don't want to throw you guys off from the conclusion. But I mean, nothing surprising or revelatory there. It's just normal stuff. But yeah. So that's where I would leave you with. I hope you liked. Again, I think this is the only thing which I wanted to show you guys on the action pieces, where I believe it will be a fun read. Right, you get all kind of action, the ones that you can imagine in a graphic novel, and then you get into the end and some variant covers, the typical ones. So I got it for a good price, that's why I picked it up. And yeah, I am not going to pick up independent Deathstroke stories for sure, unless I find that it's something really brilliant. But yeah, this one was a fun read, and I may pass it on to somebody else. I may not keep it. It's not something like I would want to collect and keep it, except maybe for the artwork, which tempts me to do so. But still, it's okay. You cannot buy and collect everything that you see. It becomes too much, right? So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. So that's Deathstroke, Gods of War for you. Bye-bye.